Hey there, and welcome back to another video. Unisharpay is here, and in this video, I'm going to show you 7 ways how you can improve the build speed for your Gradle project inside Android Studio. We will show 7 tips alongside a bonus tip at the end of the video, so make sure you watch it to the end. The first tip is to make sure that you keep your Android tools up to date. The tools are Android Studio, Gradle plugin for Android, and the Android SDK tools. All right, so if you go to your Android projects here, in the build Gradle file, make sure you have the up-to-date dependencies, and in the build Gradle.project file, you may see that I'm having here Kotlin plugin or the Gradle plugin. It is 7.0.3 at the time of this recording. Now, you can click or Alt Enter here to change it to the latest version. Okay, sync it, and you are using the latest Android Gradle plugin, all right? The next thing here is to check that the Android Studio you are using is the latest one. Okay, just go to help and check for updates. And if there is any update, you will pop up with an update or a dialog to update your Android Studio. I'm sure, yes, there is an update. I didn't update my Android Studio yet. So this is the first tip. Make sure you keep your tools up to date in Android. All right. The second tip here is to enable the Gradle daemon. Now, Gradle daemon is a process that will run at the background. It will take some amount of memory, but it will make sure that it will keep Gradle fur tasks, I think, running, and also keep some data in order to make the successive builds much more fast. So to enable it, just go to Gradle property, and here, just type Gradle daemon to true, and sync it. This is it. You can also enable parallel Gradle task, this one, and sync it. This will make sure when you have a project with multiple modules, you can have Android application with multiple modules. This will make sure that the build of each module is done in parallel. Okay. The third tip is to use more memory, just simple like that. Well, you can go here and see the memory you are allocating for Gradle daemon. Here we are allocating 2 GB of memory. Okay. You can change it here, and you can also see it here in the setting. Just type here the heap. And we can see that the heap max size for the IDE, to make the IDE run smoother, I'm using 8 GB. But for the daemon and the Kotlin daemon and the Gradle daemon, I'm using just 2 GB. If you have more memory in your computer, you can just allocate more memory. You can well use like 4 GB like that. And also, well, you can use 8 GB. Okay, and you have more, you can use more. Okay, so just sync it and you are ready to go. Now, with the fourth tip is to make sure that the dependencies are not dynamic. Try to use an exact version for your dependencies. Well, you can find your dependencies here in the build Gradle file here. Under the dependencies, you must use exact versions like that. Don't use this one. These are dynamic versions, so you must search for the specific version you want to use. Here, I'm just going to use 0.13.1, I think. Something like that. Sync it. I think there is another version, 13.2. Nice. Just 2. Sync now. And you are ready to go. So the conclusion here is to use an exact version for the dependencies. Don't use dynamic versions for your dependencies. Now, with tip number 5. Is to use WebP extension for images instead of JPEG and PNG. Why? Because when the build kick off, well, we need to understand what the build Gradle build is doing. Gradle is trying to compact all your files, your resource file, your code file into one single APK. So it will need to compile the files, sync it with, compile the file of Kotlin, sync it with the resources and everything. Now, part of the build is to compress the images. Now, PNG compression and JPEG compression is somehow it will take more times. So changing it to WebP extension will make the build time for the compression much more faster. All right. Now it might take more CPU power, but it will make the build more fast. Okay. So if you have a PNG file, let's say I'm having an image here for 11 years later, me from SpongeBob, you can just click here and convert to WebP. All right, it will reduce somehow the quality. As you can see, there is no noticeable difference. Click finish on, and here you go. Well, you reduce the file size, that first, and also it will improve the build speed for your Gradle build speed. Now with tip number 6, it is somehow easy, just remove unused resources. So if you have unused resources like images or string files or anything else, just remove it, because that way you are making shortcut for the build Gradle to speed up. Okay, that's the first thing. You can also, while you are testing your application, because in the development phase, don't need all the resources. So let's say you have an application that contains many languages like English, Arabic, French, or any other languages, and also some different image size or densities for multiple devices. When we are testing, we can improve the build speed for just the testing purpose. Okay, so you might go here to build a Gradle file and add, I think, product flavors. Right. Now you can define product flavor just for the development purpose. Okay, here just type resource config, I think, config. You won't get any help with that. Okay. And here just type the resources things. I want to use just the English one, and I want to use XXHTTPI for the resources. Okay, so I'm using a phone that contains resources with or density pixels for XXHTTPI. Okay, and I'm using it just with English. So this way I'm improving the build speed, but just for development purposes. This will speed up the development progress. Okay, just sync it and you are ready to go. Now with the last tip number 7, sometimes in Android project, we use the ProGuard for debug also. Sometimes I've seen something like that, true, and here the debug, exactly. So the ProGuard process will make a lot of process for your application. It will do ossification for your code, it will reduce the size, shrink its size, and so on. This will take some time in order to test your application and develop it. So make sure you don't minify the application in the debug phase. Okay, just delete that or turn this to false. Okay, so these are the 7 tips I'm using to improve my own project build speed. Now keep in mind that the build speed will depend on 2 main things. It will depend on the project you are working on. So if you have big project that would contain many files and resources, it will be for sure, it will take more time than a normal project, okay? And the other thing, it will depend on the machine you are running on. So if you have good CPU and big RAM, it will run somehow faster than other machines. For the bonus tip, just try to test your application on with first real device or emulator, but with the version of Android 7.0, I think, API 24 or 23, or high. Okay, so why is that? Well, that's because recent version of Android enable support for Android runtime and multi-dex support, like multi-dex file support. Okay, so this makes sure that the build, the update, when we push the application into the phone for testing it, it will be much, much more fast. Okay, so these are the tips I'm using. Thank you very much for watching this video and making it this far. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a comment. If you have a question, leave a comment below. Thank you very much. Subscribe to the channel and see you in the next video.